who has begun a good thing, a good work in your life, in your life, he shall perfect it.
You want to know God? Go to Judah. Go to the place of praise. Go to the place of worship. I declare the worship you gave to Jehovah this morning. He will show himself strong in your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I will build my church and the gate of hell shall not prevail. I dedicate you. I declare there's a voice in the realm of the spirit calling your blessing to come.
Amen.
Calling your miracle to come.
Amen.
I declare it shall obey.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, those three things that Apostle Paul prayed for the believers, the first one have taken place. The grace of God has been made available already. What is left now is the communion with the Holy Ghost.
You can't pray to prosper when you are covering up something. It won't work. You are praying in vain.
If I have, I can't touch it like this because of the pain. It did not allow me to hold like this because of this pain. This pain is disappearing now. I'm not seeing this pain.
Leave God!
She's feeling that now.
She cannot need that like this. Look at
your breast.
Precious Father, we dedicate this moment. We ask, precious Lord, that you speak to us. This is the first Sunday of the second half of the year. We need a word from you. Let it be something that will be a blueprint as we go through the second half of this year. We have known from record that any time you speak, that blessings rest upon your people. We are expecting it today. Thank you, blessed Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I'll be speaking on the topic entitled Coming Out of the Wilderness.
Amen.
Now, somebody said to this video, The wilderness experience is not optional. It's not optional. Everyone passes through it. So much the wilderness.
Wilderness.
No! The wilderness, by definition, is a period of a desert experience. A desert experience when effort do not produce expected result. You till the ground. It doesn't grow because it's a wilderness. It's a desert ground. And unfertilizing. So a wilderness experience is an experience where helpers will not locate you. No one knows how to call this life. It's not easy to find you. A wilderness experience is where when you shout, it's come ahead now. People may hear the echo of your voice, but they can't locate your location. What is a wilderness experience? It's a period when provisions are not available. There is no store in the wilderness, no supermarket. A wilderness experience is an experience where only what you have at the point of entrance is available.
There is no opportunity to make a replacement. That's a wilderness experience. A wilderness experience is an experience where there are demons, evidence of enemies, evidence of demons, that is any animals, dangerous animals, lion, tiger, wilderness. When you dream, nightmare, horror, experiences that look as if you did the devil something and he's after you. Wilderness. Wilderness. How do you come out? A wilderness experience. It's an experience that looks as if your prayers are not heard. A wilderness experience is when it looks as if you are the only one left in the situation. Everyone is in the city. You are the only one left in the bush. A wilderness experience. It makes it look as if God is far. A wilderness experience. It's not optional. It's mandatory. God initiates a wilderness because it is a place of trial, it's a place of test, it's a place of examination. A wilderness experience is a place where your promotion is organized.
Oh,
a wilderness is a place where your promotion is arranged. A wilderness experience is a place where you are certified for the next level. A wilderness is a place where you are being inspected whether you are fit for the next responsibility. A wilderness experience is a place where all that you have been taught by God is being examined whether you have been able to perfect it. You have a thorough understanding of what you have learned. A wilderness experience is a place where your maturity is being tested. Whether you are matured, you claim to be. But a wilderness experience is a place where it is tested whether in reality you are matured. A wilderness experience is a place where hypocrites are discovered.
Oh.
It's a place where hypocrites, those who claim to be what they are not, wilderness exposes them. Those who claim they are matured, those who claim they have been long in the church, those who claim they have read the Bible, those who claim they believe God, during the wilderness, it is revealed. It's in a place of wilderness. Your identity, which you claim to have known, is investigated whether you truly know it. Thus, it's not strange. For Jesus Christ, immediately he was baptized, the heaven opened and the angels were available. The Holy Ghost
the first time he appeared physically like a dove and rested upon Jesus. I'm in the last phrase of the book of Matthew chapter 3, and I move from there to Matthew 4 verse 1. See what happened in the last phrase of Matthew 3, the last verse. Hear it carefully. But if you are in the book of Luke 3, consider verse 21-22. Is there he spoke about Jesus who was baptized in River Jordan. Go ahead, tell me what happened.
And lo, a voice from heaven
saying,
This is my beloved son.
In whom
I am well pleased.
A wilderness experience is where God tests you whether you truly believe the prophecy that you were given. You heard a good prophecy. A wilderness is a period that displays a contradiction to prophecy.
Oh.
A wilderness experience is a situation that reveals a contradiction to expectation. Jesus was just told, thou art my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased. God just spoke to Israel, I am taking you to a land of milk and honey. But when they came out, they had no water to drink. A place of contradiction to prophecy. A wilderness is where you begin to experience what looks different from what you were told. Wilderness. Everyone passes through it. Even Jesus was not an exemption. Get ready for your own. Maybe some of you are already in the wilderness experience right now. It is your attitude during your wilderness that determines how long you stay. Write it down. The length of your wilderness is not determined by the devil or by God. It's determined by your reaction to the wilderness situation. I say it again. The length of your wilderness academic career is not determined by the academic calendar of God or the academic calendar of the devil. It's determined by your attitude in the season of wilderness. How long you stay is a function of your reaction to the issues of the wilderness. God cannot help you. The devil cannot even be involved. It's you that determine how long you stay. Can you imagine that? A man that had a feeling that God was going to use him to save Israel. Moses felt it. He knew by way of intuition that Israel was suffering in a strange land, and that there's a kind of mantle upon him to deliver these people from the captivity. And the first thing God did was to send him to the wilderness. He made him commit a crime that paved his way to where?
The wilderness.
He finally went to school for 40 years before he became the savior of Israel. If you don't pass through wilderness, forget about the next level. It's a divine arrangement. Joseph had a dream that he was going to rule his father and mother and the other children. The dream was so clear. He had it two times, not once. At the mouth of two or three witnesses, the word is established. He dreamt twice. It was sure that rulership was in his custody. He saw revelation of his exploit. He knew he was going to be a star. But after the dream, they sold him into the wilderness. Some of you are right there right now, and you are querying why. No wilderness, no Cana. The land of milk and honey has only one direction, one way to Cana, wilderness. There's only one way to the promised land, wilderness. No other way. The Lord told them, there are other ways I would have made you to pass to get to the promised land. There are other ways. But I deliberately made you to pass through wilderness. I have a reason for it. Geguzugu barask. Many of you here, God have organized this wilderness you are passing through. You are blaming devil.
is God that took you there.
I will tell you.
Whoosh, verse 4. Read Deuteronomy chapter 8. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4. Is there. Write it down. Verse 4. Open it.
He said, I allowed you to pass through the wilderness because I wanted to find out what was in your heart. Go ahead, read it for me.
Thy raiment waxed not old upon thee, neither did thy foot swell these 40 years.
These 40 years.
Thou shalt also consider in thy heart that as a man chastised his son, so the Lord thy God chastised thee.
Finish it.
Thou shalt also consider in thy heart that as a man chastised his son, so the Lord thy God chastised thee. Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways and to fear him.
To walk in his ways and to do what?
To fear him.
If you begin from verse 1, the story is clear. But read verse 2.
Verse 2. And thou shalt remember all the way.
And thou shalt remember all thy ways.
Which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness.
Who led thee into the wilderness?
The Lord.
Talk to me. Who led you to wilderness?
The Lord.
Who led you to wilderness?
The Lord.
The Lord.
Demon.
The Lord.
Oh, devil. The enemy your family.
The Lord.
The Lord thy God led thee into the wilderness. A wilderness experience is organized by heaven. Look at the reason why. Go ahead.
To humble thee.
Number one. To do what?
To humble thee.
And until you learn humility, you remain in the wilderness. So you want to come out of wilderness, humble yourself. Pride will keep you longer in your wilderness. To make you depend on God, not on yourself. Finish it.
To prove thee, to know what was in thy heart.
Underline. To know what was in your heart. It is in the wilderness we know what is in your heart. Somebody told me a long time ago, a crude man from the village. Crude. He said, after marrying your wife, and you want to begin to relate with your in-law, so you have to investigate who you should relate with. Not all of them. Some of them are good, some of them are bad. Some of them didn't want this marriage to take place. So what you do? Arrange your wife in the parlor. She has not done anything. Look at her. And calculate a dangerous slap. And give her a hot slap that she will never forget.
Ewoy!
As she look and say, another one, number two, Ewoy! Say, man, what's on you? Listen to her testimony. How? Oh, yeah.
My mother told me. My mother told me about this marriage. My mother told me.
Say, write it down. Number one, your mother.
Woo! Oh, yeah. Auntie Meg warned me.
Write it down. Number two. You will soon know those who didn't want you to marry this sister. You will soon know. Because now the wilderness will bring out what was in.
Yeah.
God allow you to pass through a wilderness. Because you come to church, you are shouting, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God a miracle. God cannot find out what is in your heart. Because you are right now in the church. You can celebrate hallelujah. But when wilderness. When wilderness takes place,
hey.
You begin to say how much you know God. God, next all you be. God, where are you there? God said, I can see. God said, I allowed you to pass through wilderness because I only know what is in your mouth. I have not discovered what is in your heart. Because as a man thinketh in his heart,
hey.
That is his real identity.
Yes, sir.
You are shouting, praise God. That does not reveal your identity. You are sowing seed on the altar. That does not reveal your identity. Until I see what is in your heart, I will not know who you are. I
how to make you pass through the wilderness.
Hey. Yes.
To find out what is in your. There are many people are embarrassed. I do them some nasty things to test their heart about this ministry. There are many people I lift up, I bring them down. I will send spies around them to go and tell them how bad I am. How can pastor just do like this? How can pastor? They don't know I sent SSS. I want to know what is in their heart. When I was president, they said, Daddy Osaga. Then when I remove them from office, I will send SSS. Go and play with them. So don't mind him. You do as if now be the layman of God for town. You think it's always right. You'll be writing it down. When you are in the wilderness, your heart is revealed.
Sir.
Read that verse again. Why do God allow you to pass through wilderness?
And thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness.
And thou shalt remember that the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years into the wilderness. Go ahead.
To humble thee.
And to prove thee.
To know.
What was in thy heart.
Whether thou wouldest keep his commandments
or no. Whether
you
would keep his commandments.
Or no. And he humbled thee. And suffered thee to hunger. To hunger.
Who suffered thee to hunger?
God.
No, devil. This is Bible. He took you to a situation of no food. Are you passing through a situation of no food? You are hungry for husband, no husband. You have a hunger for baby, no baby. You have a hunger for car, no car. I suffered thee to hunger.
To hunger.
It's not devil. God is the one now saying, I am the one that didn't allow you to have what you were hungering for. It's for a while. But I want to know what was in your heart. I know what is in your mouth, but I don't know what is in your heart. Your heart is what describes you correctly. I want to know, so I have to create a no situation.
Mm-hmm.
To know what was in your heart. Can you imagine? After God has spoken, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. The next chapter, Matthew 4 verse 1. Look at what the same Bible said. After accrediting Jesus, the same Bible, hear what the Bible said.
Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit.
Jesus was led of what?
The Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Into the wilderness.
Jesus. You are baptized to be led. To the wilderness. After your baptism. After your ordination. After your appointment. After your correlation, the Holy Ghost will always lead you to the wilderness to find out what is in your heart. I pray in your wilderness experience, you will not betray your real identity.
Amen.
Three keys to coming out of the wilderness. Number
You've got to make up your mind. To believe God. The first key is believe God, no matter what is on ground. Believe him. It's not good. Believe him that it will be better. Believe him that it's going to work, all things work together for good. It is not bad. It is not good now, it's bad. But God will work it out. For what?
For good.
Talk to me. You went to school. God will work all things out together for what?
For good.
For good. It's not saying it's good. It is bad now. But it will turn it to what?
To good. Good.
Is there? Romans 8 verse 28.
Romans 8 verse 28. And we know.
And we know.
That all things.
That all things. Please talk to me. How many things?
All.
Does it include what you are passing through now?
Yes, sir.
All things. Go ahead.
Work together for good.
Work together for good.
To them that love God.
To them that love God. Now, listen carefully. Until you believe in your wilderness experience, that no matter how long it takes, no matter how bad it is, I have a confidence that I'm not going to die in the wilderness. My destination is not in the wilderness. My destination is in the promised land.
Hey.
This is not the promised land. God has a destination for me. He said, for I know the thought that I think towards you. Thoughts of peace. Is it peace? And not of evil. To give you an expected. A land of milk and honey. And the Bible said, all things work together for good.
Good.
No matter how bad it is, believe that the end will be a celebration. That is how to come out quickly from the wilderness. I read a story in the internet. Hear what happened. A tribal king went with his childhood friend who have learned this theory I'm telling you now, that no matter how bad it is, he doesn't know the Bible, so he has a positive thinking mentality. This is good. Just like he would say, all things work together for what?
For good.
It's not good, shall, but it will finally produce goodness. They went to the forest to hunt. His childhood friend went with him to shoot. So they were shooting. The gun he carried, he never knew that he had a problem. As he shot the bed flew. Prrr, and he quickly rushed to fly to shoot the bed in the air. He couldn't cock it. He didn't cock it properly. And he shot. Bah! The gun returned and shot his thumb. The thumb cut off. Blood dripping, and the first thing the childhood friend said, who is used to the slogan, "This is good." He is now a part of his life. He now said, looking at the thumb cut off and the blood spilling, he looked at the cut off thumb and looked at the blood. He said, "This is good." What do you mean? You see my finger cut off? Blood gushing out. Oh, are you the one that is I can see. I thought you were a friend. Guard, lock him up. The guard that followed the king arrested his shadow's friend and locked him up in the prison. What do you mean? This is good? He asked the guard, "Is this good? That my finger is cut? Talk to me. Is it good?" Don't mind that he called himself my friend. I am happy I locked him up and treated his finger. After 1 year, it was healed. He went again for hunting, searching for what to shoot. He searched and searched and searched and searched, and the search took him to a forest where there are cannibals. No, cannibal. Human beings that eat other human beings. They arrested the king. They caught the king. And they were jubilating that they have caught the king. They tied the king to the post where they normally eat and roast the human being they arrest. And they set fire. And the pot was on fire. And they were all dancing around the king. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Then we are celebrating. They want to fry the king. The king was shouting. No one could rescue the king. But the cannibals have a philosophy. They don't eat a human being with blemish. The human being must be a perfect human being, not an incomplete human being. So when they tied him, they were about to start slaughtering him. One of them said, "Hey, commander, commander, we can't eat this one." So what happened? He said, "One of his fingers is not complete. Lose him and let him go." The king now remembered the story of his friend. This you may be bleeding now.
Hey,
it is good.
Yes, sir.
Your finger might have been cut off.
Oh.
This is good. You might have lost your most valuable instrument. This is good. You might have lost what you so much cherish. This is good. I tell you, God knows the number of your hair.
Uh-huh.
He's counted them. Yeah. He knows why they fell off.
Uh-huh.
He knows why they were lost.
Yes, sir.
He knows why you don't have
them.
All things working together
for good.
That's not the end of my story. In the wilderness, for you to come out quickly, you've got to believe it's good. It's for my good. It will produce goodness. The story continued. The king now haven't seen that it is good. He now ran to the prison to go and beg his friend who said this is good, to appreciate him for his philosophical belief. The king knelt down and said, "My friend, I'm sorry. I apologize for putting you in prison." He said, "Why?" He said, "Let me tell you the story. I was arrested by cannibals. They wanted to fry me. They were already dancing around me. The fry was frying and the fire was firing. The knife was ready. Then suddenly they discovered that I don't have a tomb. And they said, release him. We don't eat a human being without a complete body. So I cannot see that it was good. God removed my tomb ahead of time to make me escape from losing my whole body. I lost my tomb to preserve my life." As he was saying, "This is good. This is good." The king now developed the philosophy. This is good. But my story has not ended. The prisoner friend said, "You don't need to beg me. This is good that I was imprisoned." He said, "No, it's not good. It's not good." I said, "It is good. It's not good. I did bad." He said, "It's good. I'm happy you imprisoned me. Because if I had followed you to that mountain, when they did not eat you because you didn't have tomb, me, I have a complete body."
Hey! Ah!
Oh my God!
Hey!
Somebody is hearing me right now.
Hey!
Somebody is hearing me right now.
Yes, sir.
Somebody is hearing me right
yes,
now.
Yes, sir.
I don't know what you have lost.
My God.
I don't know what is happening to you.
Jehovah.
For you to leave the wilderness.
Oh.
You have to celebrate everything and declare that this is
good.
Rise on your feet.
Woo!
Open your mouth and give thanks to God.
Ah, mighty God,
Lord,
we give you praise.
I don't know what I'm passing through. I may not understand.
Thank you, Jehovah. Lord, we lift up your name.
I don't understand what I'm passing through.
Lord, we thank you.
But I testify that
what you're passing through right now, Lord, we give you all the glory.
I give you thanks because you are the
Lord. Be the way God.
You have explanation.
You have reason for everything.
What I'm passing through.
Lord, we lift up your name. Thank you, Jehovah.
I thank you. It is good.
You have reason.
It is good.
Lord, we
see a miracle coming.
Whatever you
have, I see a change coming.
We give you all the glory.
I see a change.
Our Father, we tithe.
I see a change.
For this we produce results.
I see a change.
For this we bring better things.
It is good.
Lord, we lift up your name.
It is good.
We call it good.
It is good.
Thank you, Father.
It is good.
We give you all the praise.
It is good.
Thank God that
I
glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
for
you,
the trials
we give you all the
that
glory.
I go through now.
And we know you are
because
well.
Because it
of
is
what
good.
You are passing through.
I give you praise.
With an experience.
I give you praise.
Lord, we
I give you praise.
It will
I give you praise.
Good fruit.
It might not
Lord,
look pleasant, but it is good. It might not look well,
Lord,
but it is good.
We'll lift up
thank
name
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. It is good. It is good. It is good. Thank you, Father, for whatever I'm going through now. Because it is good.
Blessed be your name,
good.
My Father.
It is
thank
good.
You, Jehovah.
It is good.
Thank you, Jehovah.
Thank you, Lord.
The King of
in
Israel.
The mighty name of Jesus.
Want to know God? Go to Judah. Go to the place of praise. Go to the place of worship. I declare the worship you gave to Jehovah this morning. He will show himself strong in your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. I will build my church and the gate of hell shall not prevail.
I dedicate you. I declare there's a voice in the realm of the spirit. Calling your blessing to come.
Amen.
Calling your miracle to come.
Amen.
I declare it shall obey.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, the those three things that are possible for the believers, the first one have taken place. The grace of God have been made available already. What is left now is the communion with the Holy Ghost.
You can't pray to prosper when you are covering up something. It won't work. You are praying in vain.
If my hand, I can't touch it like this because of the pain. If you don't allow me to hold like this because of this pain is disappearing now. I'm not saying his name.
Mm-hmm. You got it.
Like
she's feeling that now. She cannot make that like this. Look at.
That cancer, the breast. Manda rabanya the breast.